He had long hair, he had a haircut, and his son did get a haircut also. Where does the hair go?
So, interesting enough, it just happened this week. I had a barber, a young guy who his name was Ray in North Stewart, and he passed away, unfortunately, unexpectedly, during COVID. And so I said I'm going to dedicate a year to Ray of not getting my hair cut because he was so particular, as I am, about my hair. And I could never find anybody that would cut it right and how I wanted it, and I'd have to keep going back. And so a year went on, and people asked, "Are you growing it out for a cause? Are you just growing it out?" And I said what the cause was, but I dedicated that year to Ray. And then I kept going, and then just last week at Michael Leonard's, Michael Isola cut my hair, and I gave it to an organization in San Diego that makes wigs for little boys and girls. So you had to have a certain length, a minimum of 9 inches, and I think we had up to 13 inches, which was really cool. It felt really weird on my back and my shoulders, and I got tired of paying for all the hair products that you guys have to pay for. And now I have an abundance of conditioner and a lot of like high-end shampoo. And so the day I cut it, I put the normal amount of shampoo in my hair, and I was just like, it was everywhere. So that was a very interesting thing that, you know, I would never do that again, but I'm glad I did it. Right. And so when the wig is made and it goes on the little boy or little girl, and for them to have a smile of everything they've been going through, right? We have a bad day because somebody maybe hit our car. We have a bad day because we didn't get what we needed at work, or somebody else got the position. When they're battling for their life every day and having those horrendous drugs going in them to beat something that just sucks. And so when I found the organization, and I watched the YouTube, and I've tagged it on all of my groups, I think it really made me aware that they go out and they meet the child and they find out what they want and they cater to them, and there's no cost. You know, in some groups build the wig and then there's a cost associated, and I get that, right? You can't do everything for free. But good group, and send it out there, and I'm looking forward to seeing that on little boy or little girl. So here I am, I'm back to normal. I see a lot of the grays now that I never did before. I could only see it on my beard, but it started here and it went up, and I guess it's all in here now. So
Spreading around.
yeah, you have to embrace it,
You
like
have
your
to.
health, right?
Yes.
Yeah,
It's
a
called
little weaker, a little
experience.
slower.
You're also a small business owner, a big business owner,
Small.
local business owner.
Local. So I have a little nursery, a little tree nursery.
Here on ice, just like old Hank taught us about, singing along, boasting the songs, rowdy friends all night long. Good time. Oh, we having a good time. Yeah, I've been working all week and I'm tired. I don't want to sleep and I want to have fun. It's time for a good time.
And, you know, it's a good balance from Washington, coming home to just pull weeds and to move plants and to design something that makes somebody happy. And I think that's the enjoyment out of that. I have a great crew that runs it and a great staff that maintains and cleans and repots and replants. And there were some growing pains in the beginning because you want to have everything available for everybody. And then you realize that, you know, there's eight other people on the same road selling the same thing at a better price. Or they mark it down that day and you can't sell. And so that was a lot of fun learning what our niche was. And so yeah, it's a lot of fun. Thousands and thousands of plants that I never thought I would have because I grew up in a farming family and I hated it. I hated potting plants. I hated taking bulbs out of sacks. I hated putting poinsettias in plastic wrappers because that's what my dad did. And so I wanted nothing to do with farming, and it's kind of ironic that it circles back to doing that. And then I bring my dad out, who wants to tell my son how to do it and drive the tractor and move the dump truck and drive the semi. So you have three generations on a farm that span. My dad is 82 and my son is 11. So big difference between the two, and they get along great, and that's all that matters.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so
that's
fun.
Very awesome. Is there anything you want to add?
I don't know. What do you guys think?
Nicole, it's Nicole's turn.